Chichester Clam?
What, who?
That landlubber's never gonna make safe harbor.
No, Mr.
Clam.
They took the top of a merger between the two companies. What are
they doing? George? Absolutely not. I'm just going for a walk, that's all.
Please, come on, come on.
Yep. I said he wouldn't make it.
You did, Mr. Clam.
Photographers. What's the matter, Uncle Percy?
Couldn't get to see Chichester Clam again. Are you going out? You're not going to meet that George Caffyn, I trust, Zenobia.
Don't be silly, Uncle Percy.
I will not have you associating with these theatrical good-for-nothing.
I'm going to call on Bertie Wooster.
That idler? I didn't know he was in New York.
Can we please have a little less noise, Daddy? I am trying to write.
Sorry, Florence, my dear.
Well, Jeeves, what news?
The costumiers have delivered your costume for Sunday's 4th of July ball, sir.
Abraham Lincoln?
Yes, sir.
Yes, I must say I'm looking forward to donning the old whiskers and stovepipe hat, Jeeves. Anything else?
Miss Hopwood was here earlier, sir, with Mr. Caffyn.
Was she, by Jove? I wish I'd seen the young troutling.
I gather that she and Mr. Caffyn have an understanding, sir.
Well, well, well. Time to dust off the old grey topper and sponge bag trousers, eh?
It would certainly seem so, sir, though Miss Zenobia impressed upon me the necessity of keeping the information a secret.
Really? I can't think why. Oh, talking of dusting things off, Jeeves, am I right in thinking that today is your birthday?
It's very good of you to remember, sir.
Any little gift I can get you while I'm out? The sky's the limit, Jeeves.
It's extremely kind of you, sir. There has recently been published a new and authoritatively annotated edition of the works of the philosopher Spinoza. Since you are so generous, I would appreciate that very much.
Spinoza, eh? It shall be delivered to your door in a plain van without delay.
Good morning. Oh, good morning, sir.
My book, Spinoza, collected whatnot.
I'll see if we have it in stock, sir.
Good heavens.
Fancy meeting you. And in a bookshop of all places. What trash are you reading? Spindrift. Why, Bertie, fancy you buying my novel. I must autograph it for you.
Oh, autograph it. Yes, quite. Good air.
I wish I could interest Darcy Cheesewright in something other than the Police Gazette.
Not Stilton Cheesewright. I didn't know you knew Stilton.
Darcy and I are engaged to be married. Why do you call him Stilton?
It's just what we called him in school. It's a joke.
I don't understand.
No. Well, old Stilton's not still in the police force, is he?
Well, yes, he is.
Yeah, how's that going?
Extremely well, as a matter of fact.
Oh, we don't have your Spinoza, sir, and I can get it for you for tomorrow.
Fine, if you would, yes.
Bertie, do you really read Spinoza?
Oh, rather, yes. Yes, if I have a spare moment, you'll generally find me curled up with Spinoza's latest.
Well, you know, we ought to see each other more, Bertie.
Yes, absolutely. Well, toodaloo, Florence.
Excuse me, sir. That's $1.75 for the book.
Book? Oh, yeah, yes, of course. Yes, you and Nobby Hopwood are planning to leap in among the orange blossoms, eh, Georgie?
Absolutely.
Yes, I heard the news from Jeeves and was much stirred. I've always considered Nobby to be an extremely sound young potato. Cheers. So, what did you want to see me about?
Our Uncle Percy disapproves of the match.
But why? You're one of our most eligible young bachelors. You make pots of money writing those plays of yours. And what about that offer to go to Hollywood?
Worplesdon's just suspicious of people in the theatres.
And I happen to...
Oh, no, it's Cheesewright again.
Stilton Cheesewright? How odd. I was just talking about him. Alcohol.
He's engaged to Worplesdon's daughter.
Yes, I know. Poor devil. I was engaged to her once.
Alcohol. I don't know how they're getting it, Kowalski.
What ho, Stilton?
Bertie Wooster.
The same?
What's that you're drinking?
Oh, it's dashed decent of you, Stilton. I'll have a lot.
Alcohol? I'm surprised at you, Bertie. Don't you know there are laws against alcohol in New York State?
Well, yes.
I'm over here doing a course with the New York Police Department, and I must say I'm surprised at the lax way their prohibition laws are enforced.
Well,
Cheesewright's on a one-man campaign to stiffen them up a bit.
Oh, jolly good. Well done, Stilton. Huh. You know, funnily enough, I just ran into Florence.
Oh, I wasn't aware you knew Lady Florence.
Old Florence? Oh, good Lord, yes, yes. We're old chums.
Known her long?
A certain time.
Know her well?
Pretty well. Fairly well. Well, tolerably well. I've met her, I think. Dark girl, isn't she?
Sorry to break this up. I have to get back to rehearsals. Walk back with me, will you, Bertie? See what you think of the show.
George, we're in trouble.
Oh, not again.
The girls had a meeting. They see if they don't get their money by Monday, they won't be dancing on Tuesday. They'll be walking.
Billy, talk to them.
I've talked. They're serious.
Look, tell them they'll get their money.
Hey.
Anything I can do, George?
Yes, it's quite simple, really. There's this old fellow called Chichester Clam.
Chap who owns all those boats.
Yeah. Thing is, he wants to sell all those boats to Worplesdon and retire. When he does, he's going to put $50,000 in the show.
Well, that's no problem. Worplesdon's got pots of money.
If the press get wind of it, the price of the shares will skyrocket. It won't be worth doing the deal. And they're watching him like a hawk.
Well, can't they just write each other a letter? You know, dear Clam, here's the check. Regards to all the little clams.
Apparently, it's essential that they meet to complete the deal. If we could just think of a way of arranging a meeting for them, somewhere where the press can't get at them.
Wouldn't do you and Nobby any harm with old Worplesdon either, I should imagine. Boats, eh? George, your troubles are over. Yes, the Wooster brain has slipped smoothly into gear. You leave it to me. I'll go and see Worplesdon right away.
Do you want somebody?
Yes, I do, as a matter of fact. Edwin, I want to see your father.
That's a quarter.
What do you mean, that's a quarter?
Will you give me a quarter and I won't tell them you hit me?
Why should they think I hit you?
Because I'll tell them you did.
You're a despicable little termite, Edwin. You know that.
You shouldn't spoil him, Bertie.
Ah, what ho, Florence?
Run along, Edwin, dear. Ah, what a dear little chap he is. You shouldn't have come, Bertie. Things are over between us.
Well, quite.
I do know that you are trying to change. Cultivating your mind, considering at last the serious questions in life, but it's too late, Bertie. Hello, Daddy.
Florence, my dear. What are you doing with him?
Well, Bertie's come to see you, Daddy.
Huh?
I'll leave you to it.
Not chasing round my daughter again, are you?
Oh, no. May I sit down?
I'd rather you didn't. What for?
Well, I hear that you've got a problem.
What's that got to do with you?
I think I can say, without fear of contradiction, that I've got the answer.
My dear chap, I can easily get Summers to drive you home.
It's only a 5 minutes walk.
Well, you mustn't tire yourself, you know.
Hello, Uncle Percy. Bertie, what are you doing here?
This fine young man has the answer to my problem, Zenobia. Goodbye, Wooster. I'll telephone Clam right away.
By this evening, you will be able to play on the old crummers on a stringed instrument. It's all in hand.
Hold off the larboard bow, Prendergast.
Larboard bow, Mr. Clam.
Worplesdon and Clam meet, the deal is done, and George gets his 50,000 green ones for the show.
Most satisfactory, sir.
But your master's Machiavellian wiles do not end there, Jeeves.
Sir?
Just think of it. The meeting is successfully concluded. Worplesdon, overwhelmed with gratitude, addresses Bertram in broken tones. If there's anything I can do for you, Wooster, anything,
Well, as a matter of fact, Worplesdon old biscuit there is, replies Bertram. You could let Nobby marry Georgie Caffyn.
Highly ingenious, sir.
It's going like clockwork, Jeeves.
So far, sir.
How old do you have to be before you can marry without Uncle Percy's care?
21. In a year's time.
Yeah, there you are then. Just wait a year.
But George leaves for Hollywood next month. And I don't think he ought to be allowed to go to Hollywood without a wife at his side. To keep his mind off the local fauna.
Nobby, there can be no love where there is not perfect trust.
Who told you that?
Jeeves, I imagine. Sounds like one of his.
Well, Jeeves is an idiot.
Nobby, I've just had the most brilliant idea.
Oh, no.
The trouble with that lake business is it was too complicated. Simplicity, that's the keynote.
This isn't another idea for getting Clam and Uncle Percy together.
Absolutely. Yes, the simplicity of genius is a phrase you may find springing unbidden to your lips.
Uncle Percy's never going to listen to you again.
He will this time. Jeeves, come forth. Your master has had a wonderful idea.
I want a word with you, Wooster.
Mr. Cheesewright has been waiting for you, sir.
Yes, yes, so I see. Well, thank you, Jeeves. Well, what ho, Stilton?
Don't what ho me. I know why you're in New York. You're here for a bit of snake in the grassing.
Snake in the
grassing? You came to sneak round Florence.
My dear chap.
You said you only knew Florence fairly well. Florence has now confessed that you and she had once been engaged.
Really? Good Lord, yes, yeah. Yes, you know, she's absolutely right. Yes, it comes back to me now. Yes, we were. Long time ago.
And the whole thing's over now, eh?
Oh, definitely.
Then how do you account for this? To Bertie with love from Florence?
Ah, yes, yes, that's rather amusing, that.
Listen to me, Wooster. If I catch you saying so much as one word to Lady Florence...
I wouldn't.
No. And you'd better not. And no writing to her either. No sneaky little notes delivered by some seedy go-between. I know all those games. And just remember, I'll be watching you, Wooster. You may not see me, but I'll be watching you.
Mr. Cheesewright has gone right off his cadaver, Jeeves.
Indeed, sir. He did seem somewhat overstimulated when he arrived.
I must say, Jeeves, I don't like the way that Lady Florence is looking. What are you doing, Jeeves?
Laying the table for your dinner, sir.
No, Jeeves. No, that table is the very article of furniture across which the captains of industry, Worplesdon and Clam, will be meeting each other face to face at last in about 10 minutes' time.
You'll pardon me asking, sir, but I'm made to understand that this apartment is to be the venue for another attempt at a secret meeting between Lord Worplesdon and Mr. Clam?
You are indeed, Jeeves. Yes, the legendary Wooster Cunning, never far below the surface, has bobbed up once again. Even if the press should follow him, what could be more natural than that Lord Worplesdon should be paying a social call on an old family friend? And Chichester Clam could come up by the back stairs.
Rather a long climb for an elderly gentleman, sir?
Longish, Jeeves, longish. These tycoons are tough, though, you know.
Lord Worplesdon, what do you got to tell us?
How about a statement, Lord Worplesdon?
Gentlemen, this is a purely private visit to an old family friend, Mr. Bertram Wooster.
But what about the clam deal?
There is no clam deal. Are
you sure?
That's not what we've heard. Oh, this is just ridiculous.
Hey, get back! Get back!
What?
Get back!
What is happening?
Good evening, Lord Worplesdon.
Yes. Here, Wooster. I think this might work, you know.
Bound to. Is the back door open, Jeeves?
Yes, sir.
Would you... Oh.
Oh.
They're always late, these tycoons.
Chichester Clam is never late. Where's the back entrance?
Stilton?
Darcy Cheesewright is an uncouth Cossack.
Isn't that one of those things clergymen wear?
He told me about his visit to you last night. I can only apologize to you from the bottom of my heart.
Oh, well, think nothing of it.
But he had no right to talk to you the way he did. He doesn't own me.
No.
And I told him as much. I told him that modern enlightened thought looks on marriage as a partnership between equals. He then says something unforgivable about modern enlightened thought.
Yes, well, look, Florence, I mean, old Stilton, good Lord, I bet your remorse is gnawing at him. You know, he loves you devotedly. This is official, I happen to know.
Whether he loves me or not is not at issue.
Well, he's also very fond of modern enlightened thought. He said so only the other day. You know, if you give Stilton the bum's rush, you'll kick yourself for the rest of your life.
Oh, Bertie, you are extraordinary. So quixotic. It's what I love about you. Nobody hearing you would dream it is your dearest wish to marry me yourself.
Well...
No, let us have no more misunderstandings. Oh, I'm only thankful I've seen the meaning of your shy overtures in time. I will be your wife, Bertie. I will.
I'm engaged to Florence again.
Oh, well, congratulations. That's a bit sudden, isn't it?
Yes, well, Florence is like a volcano. You go around thinking it's been extinct for centuries, and suddenly you're covered in red-hot lava.
Sure, sure. This number's not working, you know. How did it go, by the way?
Go? How did what go?
Your plan with Worplesdon.
It was a disaster. Stilton Cheesewright arrested the party of the second part.
Clam and Worplesdon didn't get to meet?
Yeah, I've just told you.
So I don't get the money for the show?
Huh? Well, I suppose not.
Forget about getting Clam and Worplesdon together. Let's concentrate a minute on the other matter, my engagement to Nobby. How about this? Suppose some great blustering brute barges into old Worplesdon's study at 10 sharp tomorrow morning and starts calling him every name under the sun and generally making himself thoroughly offensive.
What?
I'm waiting outside the study window, and at the psychological moment, I stick my head in and in a quiet, reproving voice say, "Stop, Bertie!"
Bertie?
The brute's name's Bertie. I stick my head in and I say, "Stop, Bertie! You are strangely forgetting yourself. I cannot stand idly by and listen to you abuse a man I admire and respect as highly as Lord Worplesdon."
Hold on a minute. If you think I'm going to go marching into Worplesdon's study and start hurling abuse at him, you've got another thing coming.
You mean you won't do it?
No.
Well, that's a great pity, Bertie, because you won't be able to use the method I've thought of for extricating people from the clutches of Florence.
What method?
The Georgie Caffyn method. Simple, but effective.
Well, why can't I use it?
Because you don't know what it is.
Well, you could tell me.
No, Bertie. The Caffyn method can only be imparted to real friends. Ones who are as true as steel.
Well, I never thought you'd stoop to blackmail, Georgie.
Then you'll do it.
Absolutely not. Under no circumstances. Mm.
want you, Wooster?
Look, I didn't do anything. I was an innocent bystander.
Florence says she wants to marry you.
A misunderstanding. You know how these things happen.
No, I don't.
Do you think I want to marry the blasted woman?
What?
Well, of course I do. I do, but I know it can never be. Not while a finer, more deserving spirit like yourself is standing about with nothing to do.
Oh, I'll have something to do, Wooster. I'll be busy tearing your ears off.
Oh, what ho, Florence? I best not tell Lord Worplesdon it's my idea, Mr. Clam. We don't exactly hit it off. Not after those other disasters.
If this deal is going to go through at all, I've got to be able to announce it at my AGM next Tuesday. Now, I'd dress up in a monkey suit if that was the only way to meet with Worplesdon.
Well, since you mention it, sir, it seems to us that it might well be possible to arrange a meeting if one of the parties is, as it were, invisible.
Any sign yet, Jeeves?
No, sir. Here he comes now, sir.
Keep me posted, will you?
He's approaching the cages now, sir.
No! Jeeves, sit down!
Worplesdon mustn't know we're here until afterwards.
He's approached the wrong cage, sir.
What's wrong with the old idiot?
Pretty good outfit, Clam.
Worplesdon! Over here, you chump!
Getting serious, Jeeves. I've got to find out what this method of George's is for getting rid of Florence.
When I was in service with Lord Worplesdon, sir, Mr. Fittleworth contracted an engagement to Lady Florence.
Boko Fittleworth did? I never knew that. This tendency on the part of the human race to rush around getting engaged to Florence is absolutely inexplicable. But what happened to Jeeves?
Mr. Fittleworth suffered many an indignity at the hands of the Honourable Edwin, sir.
As have we all, Jeeves.
Yes, indeed, sir. The opportunity for Mr. Fittleworth to avenge himself for these slights came one afternoon in the garden. He chanced upon the Honourable Edwin bending over a flower border collecting caterpillars.
Go on, Jeeves.
Unable to resist the temptation, Mr. Fittleworth raised his boot and applied it to the Honourable Edwin's fundament. Unknown to Mr. Fittleworth, however, Lady Florence was seated nearby reading an improving book. Incensed and horrified by the assault, she rebuked Mr. Fittleworth roundly and shortly afterwards announced an end to their betrothal.
Good grief, Jeeves. It's the simplicity of it. It just catches one in the throat.
It is moving, isn't it, sir?
But I don't want to go in the garden.
Yes, you do, Edwin. It's nice. The birds are singing.
I don't like birds.
Your father told me he dropped some money out there.
Money?
Yes.
Did Mr. Wooster say what he wanted, Jeeves?
No, Lady Florence, merely that it was a matter of some import.
I can't see anything. How much was it?
Oh, a lot. Yes, look there. I think I saw something gleam.
What? Down here?
Yes.
It's uncanny, isn't it? This bond we have between us. How did you know that is just what I wanted to do myself? Edwin, just go to your room. I paid the little monster $2 to paste in the newspaper cuttings of the reviews of Spindrift into my album, and he's put them in the wrong way up. Jeeves said you wanted to see me, Bertie.
No, it doesn't matter now. No, I'd better be going.
Shall you be at the 4th of July ball, Bertie?
Yes, I suppose so. I've got the whiskers now.
Good. I'm going as the spirit of resurgent womanhood. You're being difficult.
If he means I won't insult your uncle, he's right.
You mean you won't help us?
Not if it means inflaming your Uncle Percy, no.
Oh, but it's a terrific method.
I'll be the judge of that. You tell me what it is.
No, Bertie. Tomorrow morning, you insult Uncle Percy, George comes in and defends him, then we tell you the method.
Don't you trust me? I'd sleep so much easier tonight knowing I wasn't going to be engaged to Florence tomorrow.
I don't care how you sleep, Bertie. As long as you're in Uncle Percy's study at 10 o'clock tomorrow morning, insulting away.
Now stop, stop, stop! This number's not working. Suppose we put the scene where Bobby proposes to Maisie before it. That'd mean writing a new song for Maisie, but I can do it tonight and have it ready first thing tomorrow morning.
Well, there's nothing else for it, Jeeves. This is being beastly to Lord Worplesdon Day.
Yes, sir. Miss Zenobia delivered this for you earlier.
Earlier? Is there an earlier?
She said that it contained all you need know in relation to Lord Worplesdon, sir.
It certainly does, Jeeves. Good Lord, I never knew that. I can't say all that to Lord Worplesdon, Jeeves. I mean, look at it.
Does seem somewhat intemperate, sir. The references to his lordship's eating habits are particularly unfortunate. Lord Worplesdon has been sensitive to such matters ever since the first Lady Worplesdon remarked that he ate artichokes like a rabbit gnawing at a fence post.
Well, we can only hope that George comes in and interrupts me before I get to the really bad bits.
Wooster, my dear fellow, just the chap I wanted to see. Me? Have a drink, Bertie.
Well, it's a bit,
Nonsense. It's never too early to have a glass of brandy. Well, first and foremost, I want to express my appreciation for your fine taste and judgment in booting young Edwin yesterday. I heard about it last night. Sent me up to bed with a warm glow, Bertie, I can tell you.
Yes, what do you see?
Thinking over some of our recent meetings, Bertie, I fancy you may have run away with the idea that I'm a bad-tempered, cross-grained old chap. You must make allowances, Bertie. You can't judge a man with a son like Edwin by the same standards as men who haven't got a son like Edwin.
Yes. Now, look here, Worplesdon.
Yes, my dear fellow.
I want to say something to you about your method of eating artichokes.
How did it go?
Where's George?
What do you mean, where's George?
Well, he was meant to come in and interrupt me. He didn't turn up.
Oh, I could kill him sometimes.
Wait a minute. What about telling me the method you've got for getting rid of Florence?
Oh, Bertie, always thinking of yourself.
Well, I've done my bit.
No, you haven't. You've got to get Uncle Percy's approval for me to marry George. That was the arrangement.
Good afternoon, Mr. Caffyn.
No, Jeeves, it's not. Bertie, it's over.
What is?
My engagement to Nobby.
Oh, she found you, did she? Well, serves you right. Where were you when I needed you?
I fell asleep. I didn't wake up till Nobby was banging on the door. I don't know where girls get these expressions from, Bertie.
What expressions?
Well, I couldn't repeat them, not with gentlemen present. It was the most extraordinary feeling. You got the sensation of something small and shrill whirling about like being attacked by a deranged Pekingese.
Well, how did it all end?
I'm not sure. Depends what construction you put on the words I never want to see or speak to you again in this world or the next, you miserable fathead.
Oh, that's nothing, Georgie.
Just making conversation, you think?
What? If I were to tell you the number of times I've heard that from a girl, you can't go by what a girl says when she's giving you hell. It's like Shakespeare. Sounds well enough, but it doesn't actually mean anything.
Well, I hope you're right. Try and think of something, will you? I gotta get back to rehearsals.
Well, Jeeves?
It has occurred to me, sir, that your original plan might still be made to perform its function.
Which particular original plan would that be, Jeeves? I've rather lost track.
The one in which Lord Worplesdon, out of gratitude to you for arranging his secret meeting with Mr. Clam, gives his consent to the betrothal of Mr. Caffyn and Miss Zenobia, and they, in turn, tell you the way to extricate yourself from your unfortunate engagement to Lady Florence.
Well, that's all very well, Jeeves, but we're overlooking one point. We haven't got the slightest idea of how to arrange the secret meeting.
If I might be permitted to make a suggestion, sir, it's well known that Mr. Clam is attending the fancy dress ball at the Empire State Building. If Lord Worplesdon were also to attend...
You mean they'd both be in costume, so the press wouldn't be able to recognize them?
Precisely, sir. I happen to know that Mr. Clam is attending the event in the guise of Edward the Confessor, and I thought perhaps Lord Worplesdon, echoing the maritime nature of his business, would look well in a Sinbad the Sailor suit.
Jeeves, I think this is it.
And we have a dozen reports of pickpockets operating in the 34th Street and Broadway area, so keep a lookout for anyone loitering. That's all, men. Yes, Cheesewright.
There's a charity ball at the Empire State Ballroom tonight, Captain Corrigan.
And?
I've heard that hard liquor is to be served there, sir.
Well, this is a private party, Cheesewright. We pretty much keep out of that sort of affair.
Well, I don't think that's right, Captain Corrigan.
Oh, you don't, eh, Cheesewright?
No, sir, I don't. The law's the law.
Okay, Cheesewright, what do you think we should do about it?
Disguise, you say?
All the guests will be in disguise, my lord. The occasion is a fancy dress one.
Quite. I'd forgotten that. Quite. I see what you mean. I'll do it. Dash it, Jeeves, I'll do it.
First rate, Jeeves.
Thank you, Sam.
Bertie.
Who on earth are you meant to be, George?
Isn't it obvious? I'm Edward the Confessor.
Edward you can't go as Edward the Confessor. Chichester Clam's going as Edward the Confessor.
What's all they had left? Apparently they bought in a job lot from Hollywood.
From Mr. Frederick Flowerdew's latest epic, sir, Edward and Hardy Canute, Knights of Passion.
Well, this won't do, Jeeves.
If you'll allow me, sir.
Anyway. Even old Worplesdon isn't going to mistake me for Chichester Clam.
Well, Florence is going as the spirit of regurgitated womanhood.
I don't like the sound of that.
Yeah, well, we may as well try and enjoy this function, Georgie. If it doesn't work this time, I'm going to be married to Florence, and you're going to be standing on the corner of Broadway and 42nd Street asking passers-by for the price of a new Broadway musical, complete with leading man, soubrette, and full chorus.
I think you'll find that satisfactory, sir.
Yeah, that's better. Come along, Georgie. Off to the dance. I'm sorry you shan't be coming with us, Jeeves.
That's very kind of you, sir. I shall be most at home with my Spinoza. Well, enjoy a pleasant evening, Your Majesty, Mr. President.
Too much to be sober, Captain Corrigan.
The bar ain't serving nothing but soda pop, Cheesewright.
They're getting it somewhere.
What?
They couldn't keep us apart this time, Walt.
Get out of here, you loony.
The confessor.
Never mind. Look out, you know that?
What's that?
Take a puff.
I've been thinking, Bertie.
Ah, right.
A quiet ceremony, I think. Just close family and a few friends.
Ceremony?
Our wedding, Bertie. Do buck up.
The wedding, yes, right. You know, it's awfully hot in here. I'm starting to feel a bit faint.
A little bit cooler on the roof.
The roof, right, yes. Well, I think I'll...
I'll come with you. Let me find Zenobia first.
Pardon me, Mr. Clam.
Speak up, young man.
I believe you are looking for Lord Worplesdon.
Yeah?
Allow me to take you to him. Pardon me, my lord, but this is Mr. Chichester Clam.
Oh, hi there, Worplesdon.
Clam! I've been looking for you everywhere.
If I might suggest, gentlemen, that you repair to the observation platform, I think that there you should be undisturbed by the press.
It's been a mighty long voyage, Worplesdon. I'm parched. Where can we get a drink before we go aloft?
I'll show you.
Captain Corrigan, I found two men drinking.
Well, Cheesewright, I don't think we actually...
Oh, come on, sir. They're going up on the roof.
Oh, God. Hold this. Thank you.
Here, this way.
What?
Come on. They're on the roof.
$10 million, not a penny less.
Eight, nine, done.
Oh, my God!
I'm sorry, Bill. No, the real Lord Worplesdon.
ceremony, we thought. Didn't we, darling?
Quiet, yes.
Zenobia, I've got to talk to you.
Do you know this person, Lawrence?
Yes. Oh, it's a bit chilly, actually. I think I'll go and put my vest on.
Bertie! Bertie's very confused. He's feeling faint.
Wait, wait for the companionway!
What?
It's here!
What about the treasure?
Up the tower!
Here!
Superior officer!
Sorry, sir. He's a slippery customer. He got in the wrong position.
Darcy! What on earth is going on?
Hello, Florence.
I have nothing to say to you, George Caffyn.
Come here, Wooster! Worplesdon, break your spine, you snake!
Wooster!
They'll hear your teeth rattling down your throat back in England! Come here, you snake in the grass! I'm gonna tear your head off and use it as a doorstop! Wooster! Where's the crow's nest on these things?
By God, they're gaining on us!
It's Uncle Percy!
Get them down.
What a story. Tycoons and rooftop lightning drama.
What about the takeover story?
Nah, that's nothing.
Yeah, who cares? This is human interest. Songwriter saves millionaire from radio mass doom.
Right.
Gee, that guy's a hero!
Oh, Georgie!
This is the scoop of the year!
Yeah! Oh, Bertie! Are you all right?
What an extraordinary feeling.
Bertie! It's Spindrift. It's my novel. You've been using my novel to line your hat. How dare you?
Floating on feathers.
I never want to see you again, Bertie Wooster. Darcy. Oh, my poor darling.
We cannot adequately know particular things. Either our own bodies or external objects, except by interrelation.
Darcy!
Thus, all sense experience, which is the mental correlate of the action of external things on our own bodies,
and all unscientific generalization from that sense experience.
It's Spinoza! Oh, he's found his true self at last!
Chichester Clam and Skyscraper Love Triangle.
What love triangle?
Hey, we'll think of something.
Oh, George, you were so brave.
Bye, Joe. The bathtub gin packs Walt.
Terrible, terrible.
What are you going to say? We're going to have another one.
Good thinking, Worplesdon.
Uncle Percy, I'm going to marry George.
Of course you are, my dear. Absolutely. Good luck to you both. Come along, Clam.
Just as a matter of interest, Nobby, what was your method of freeing me from the thrall of old Florence?
What do you mean?
Well, you know, I got your uncle to approve your nuptials, and in return you were going to tell me how to oil out of getting hitched to Florence.
Oh, don't be silly, Bertie. We didn't have any method.
You didn't have any... You mean it was all moonshine? You let me risk life and limb, and you hadn't got the slightest idea?
Oh, we'd have thought of something. Wouldn't we, George?
Sure we would.
Well, I'll be dashed.
Most extraordinary thing, electricity, Jeeves.
So I understand, sir.
I feel quite rejuvenated, if that's the word.
It is possible, sir. Galvanotherapy enjoyed a brief vogue a few years ago.
Yes. Well, anyway, you'll be glad to hear that my schemes all work like a dream. Worplesdon and Clam brought together, their companies merged satisfactorily, ditto Nobby and George Caffyn.
That is good news, sir.
But best of all, Lady Florence and Stilton reunited and heading for the altar at about 90 miles an hour, leaving Bertram as unencumbered as when the whole dratty thing started. Frankly, I blame Spinoza, Jeeves.
Sir?
If I hadn't gone to that bookshop and bumped into Lady Florence, then the whole thing would never have got going in the first place.
True, sir. So all in all, an enjoyable evening?
Highly enjoyable, Jeeves. Yes, you should have been there.
Oh, that's very kind of you, sir, but I hardly think it was my sort of occasion.
No, well, chacun a son goût, Jeeves.
Very true, sir. Will that be all, sir?
Yes, Jeeves, that'll be all. Good night.
Good night, sir.